morning students. Today I will tell you the properties of solid, liquid and gas in class 9 chemistry. That is, lesson is matter in our surroundings. You all know what is matter. Matter means anything which has mass and occupies space. That is called matter, and there are three states of matter: solid, liquid and gas. Today we'll study about the different properties of the solid, liquid and gas. Now first we'll study about the properties of solid. Solid have fixed shape and fixed volume. Means solid, whatever the solid, it is a stone or a book or a pencil or a bottle, that all these things are solid and they have fixed shape and fixed volume. They cannot be compressed much, means they cannot press it much, it cannot be broken easily, and they have high densities. Solids do not flow, they fill their containers completely. Means these all properties of solid, why they have fixed shape, why they can be cannot be compressed easily, why they have high densities, why they do not flow, and why they fill their containers completely. The reason behind is that, for the first, the reason is that the space between the particles. In solid, we all know that in solid the particles or the molecules or the atoms, they are very close. Because of the close, the particles, they are very close to each other. That's why the particles cannot move from their position. Means they move in their own position and they do not move from one place to another, or one space where it is present. Means no intermolecular space is present. So the space between the particles is very less. That is the main reason that they have fixed volume, fixed shape and fixed their high densities. Second is the force of attraction between the particles. The particles are very close together, that's why the force of attraction, or the we can say the they have strong force of attraction. They cannot be broken easily, or they cannot, the molecules cannot be made apart easily. So that's why they have fixed volume and fixed shape. That is also the reason. And the main third one is the amount of movement of particles. The amount of movement of particle means the particles are so close that they cannot move from their position, means they move in their own place where they are. So that is the three main reason behind why they have fixed shape, why they have fixed volume, and why they cannot be compressed much, and they have high densities as well as they do not flow. I mean they cannot be moved from one place to another until and unless some external force is applied on it. Second main properties of gases, we all know the properties of, before studying the properties of gas, first let's study the properties of liquid. So if we take the properties of solid, just is the properties of liquid. Solids have fixed shape and fixed volume, but liquid have no fixed shape, but they have a fixed volume. So that is the main difference between solid and liquid. We have to study the comparative study between the solid, liquid and gas. Then only we are able to understand what are the different properties of solid, liquid and gas. Now liquids can be compressed lightly, whereas solids cannot be compressed much, whereas the liquid can be compressed lightly. And the reason also is the same thing, that in liquid there is some intermolecular space, and because of this the force of attraction is also less than solid, and they can be moved easily, they can be compressed lightly, and they have a fixed, they do not have a fixed shape, but they have a fixed volume, and they can be filled in the containers. Now they have moderate densities. Like solid have high densities, liquid have moderate densities, means neither much neither low, means less than solid but more than liquid. And liquid can be flown, is they can be flow easily, means they, if we pour a drop of water, drop of means filled with a glass of water and try to pour it, then it will flow where the space it will occupy, means they will go in that particular area. So means we can say that the water can be, or the liquid can be flown easily. So that is also the reason that the interparticle space between the particles between the molecules, they are loose. That's why they have less interparticle force of attraction, but their interparticle space is more than solid. And so these are the different properties of liquid. Now the properties of gases. Gases, the properties are different from solid and liquid. Gases have neither a fixed shape nor a fixed volume. So because the gases, in gases the particles are very free from each other. That's why they have neither a fixed shape nor a fixed volume. They can be compressed easily. That's why they can be used in the cylinders and all, because they can be easily compressed. They have low densities and they can fill their containers completely. So they can fill their containers completely as well as they can flow easily, because the reason is that here also in gases, this is the structure of a solid, this is the structure of liquid, and this is the structure of gas. So in gas, what happens? The particles are very free from each other. So they have they can be easily flown, we can say. The interparticle space is much between the particles. The force of attraction is least between the particles, and they have very low density because the particles are very free. So they can be compressed easily, whereas the liquids can be compressed lightly, whereas the solid can be compressed, cannot be compressed. So that the main reason behind the different properties of solid, liquid and gas is that the particle, the position of the particles. In gases, the particles are very loose, means very free. In liquid, it is loose, some interparticle space is present, whereas in solid, the particles are very close to each other, and because of the closely packed particles, the force of attraction is also strongest in solid, whereas in liquid it is less force of attraction, whereas in gases it is least force of attraction. So these are the properties of solid, liquid and gases.